Welcome to ECE 3300 at the University of Utah. In lecture number 22, we're going to talk about Faraday's and Lenz's law. Faraday's law is very interesting because it says that a changing magnetic field produces an electric field and thus a voltage and a current. Faraday was considering the case where the current produces the magnetic field. We've seen this before. Current produces a magnetic field. Doesn't matter if it's an AC current or a DC current. And he hypothesized that if that's the case, then the magnetic field also ought to produce a current. But this only happens if there's a variation in time. Lenz's law noted that a changing magnetic field produces yet another magnetic field that opposes that change. So let's consider Faraday's experiments. I hope that you'll take a minute and watch the videos of Faraday's law experiments that we've got up on the internet. So right here, let's just take a loop and let's put a current meter across it so that we can measure how much current is in this loop. If we have a magnetic field that is passing through the loop, like so, if that is changing with time for any reason, then we see a current. If the magnetic field is static, even if it's there and large, we won't see this changing current. So let's consider three ways that we might change the current going through that loop. One way is to use a permanent magnet and move it. There are several videos of pushing a bar magnet in and out of this loop. The current meter is only going to be moving while the magnet is, and as soon as the magnet comes to rest, the current is going to stop. A second way that we might change the current in this loop is to set up a second loop. Let's set up one loop right here like this, which has our current meter on it, and let's set up another loop, or even a set of loops, over here with a battery with a switch, so that we can open or close the switch of the battery. This would produce a current in this loop, and thus a magnetic field going through like this, and the magnetic field would be changing with time when the switch is open or closed. The magnetic field is going to be picked up in the second loop, and so when the switch is either being opened or being closed, we'll see a current in this second loop. So this is magnetic induction, and that is switching or changing dB by dt. Now a third way that we could change the amount of magnetic field that is going through this is have a DC magnetic field, but change the loop. So if, for instance, we were to have a loop with a rod on it, where the rod could slide in or out over a static magnetic field, as the surface is changing, as the surface that's inside here is changing, then we would also be seeing current generated in that loop. Now there are several important concepts that we need to understand when we're looking at Faraday's law. One concept is the concept of magnetic flux. Magnetic flux is just an integral of the magnetic flux density over a surface. This is an open surface, not a closed surface, so let's take the surface of my loop like this. Suppose that my magnetic flux density is coming out of the board. I simply add up all of the magnetic flux density that's inside this loop. In this case, it would be an integral over x and y of some magnetic field, and that would be the magnetic field in the z direction, if this were the z-directed loop, dotted with a z-directed surface, for example. So flux is telling us the total magnetic flux density that's passing through that loop. And then there's another nice thing, which is the electromagnetic force voltage. If we're able to see the current changing, then we've got to assume that there's also a voltage across the terminals of this device. That is found by the number of turns of the loop times the change of flux with time. Now remember, the change of flux can be changed by changing the magnetic field or by changing the surface.